Hello friends, tenses are the basic part of grammar. So today we are going to learn the types of tenses with the help of the structures. So all of you know that there are three main types of tenses. The first one is present tense. The second one is past tense. And the third one is future tense. So these three types are again divided into four subtypes, means total 12 subtypes are there, but the main types of tenses are only three: present tense, past tense and future tense. So first we will see the present tense. It is divided into four subtypes. The first subtype of present tense is simple present tense. So we will see when simple present tense is used. When we want to express any habitual action or any universal truth, then we use the simple present tense. For example, the sun rises in the east. Here we will take another example. He writes a letter. So can you tell me which is the subject here? Yes. He is the subject, verb writes, this is a verb, and a letter, this is an object. So in simple present tense, we use basic verb after the subject. But according to the subject, means if it is a singular, then we can add s or es to the basic verb. If the subject is plural, then we write only basic verb. For example, they write, you write, we write. But if the subject is singular, then we will add here s or es. That's why we have written here he writes a letter. The second type is present continuous tense or present progressive tense. Continuous means the action is going on. So we will convert this sentence into present continuous tense. He is writing a letter. So what changes we have done here? After the subject, we have written here is. Means in present tense, the to be verbs are used, that is am, is or are. If there is I, you can use am. If there is singular subject, he, she, it, then you can use is. If the subject is plural, they or we, then we will write here are. So here the subject is singular, that's why we have written here is. Plus, we have added ing to the basic verb. As I have already told you that ing shows that the action is going on. So we will write here V plus ing, and this is an object. So we will write here O. The third type is present perfect tense. When we call any verb as perfect, when the verb is completed, we can call that it is a perfect verb. Means here also the action is completed or perfect. So we will convert this sentence into present perfect tense. He has written a letter. So you can identify the changes. Here we have written subject plus, according to the subject, we have to use here have or has. If the subject is singular, then we will write here has. If the subject is plural, then we will write here have. He has. So we will write here has or have. If we take a plural subject. For example, we have, they have, you have. Okay? But the subject is singular, that's why we have written here has. Then we, here we have written the third form of the verb, that is written. Write, wrote, written. Written is the third form of the verb. That's why we have to write here we three, or you can call it past participle, PP, plus this is an object. And the fourth type of present tense is present perfect continuous or progressive tense. So we will convert this example into present perfect continuous tense. Here some action is completed and some action is going on. That's why we have written that present perfect continuous tense. Let's see the example. He has been writing a letter. So can you tell me which changes we have done here? Yes, this is the subject plus here we have written has been or have been. Plus we plus we have added the ing to the main verb, so we will write here we plus ing plus object. Here we have used have or has of present perfect tense and we have added there been after have or has. Has been or have been according to the subject. If subject is singular, then you can write has been. If the subject is plural, you can write have been. Then we have written verb and we have added ing to the verb and the object. So past tense and future tense is also divided into four subtypes. Let's see the past tense. So the first type of past tense is also same. Simple past tense. We will take this example and we will convert this example into simple past tense. Convert this example into simple past tense. He wrote a letter. What changes we have done? The subject is same here. Here we have written second form of the verb, that is V2. Here first form we have used. Here we have used the second form of the verb. Wrote plus this is an object. S plus V2 plus object. The second subtype of past tense is past continuous or progressive tense. Take this example and convert it into past continuous tense. He, here we have used to be's verb, that is am, is, are, but in past tense the to be's verbs are used as was or where. If the subject is singular, you will write here was. If the subject is plural, you will write where. For example, they were, we were. But here subject is singular, that is he. That's why we have written here was. He was writing a letter. This is the subject. Plus, according to the tense, to be's verbs are used was or were. Plus, verb plus ing plus object. Only here we have used am, is, are. Here we have not written am, is, are, but we have to use am, is, or are. subject plus was where, plus verb plus ing plus object. So the third type of past tense is past perfect tense. We will convert the same example into past perfect tense. He plus, here we have used have or has. In past tense, we use the helping verbs only had. If the subject is singular or plural, we have to use only had. He had written a letter. So what changes we have done here? Subject plus had plus V3, or you can call it past participle PP plus object. The fourth subtype of past tense is past perfect continuous tense. Means here we have to use ing of continuous tense and had of perfect tense. Only we will add been after the had. He had been writing a letter. So you will understand that we have used here subject plus had been plus V plus ing plus object. Okay. Then our third type is future tense. We will convert this also into four subtypes. That is, first one is simple future tense. We will convert the same example into simple future tense. He will write a letter. It is same as simple present tense, but here we have to write will or shall. So when will or shall we have to write? If the first person pronoun is there, for example they or we, then we can write shall. If the second or third person pronoun is there, then we will write will. Or if you are confirmed about an action, then also you can write will. So in future tense, two these verbs are used, will or shall. So the structure is subject plus will or shall plus V, or you can call it V1, the basic verb is there, plus object. The second subtype of future tense is future continuous or progressive tense. We will convert this example, same example, into future continuous tense. He will be writing a letter. So as it is a continuous tense, we have added here ing to the verb. So the structure is subject plus will be or shall be plus V plus ing plus object. Okay. The third type of future tense is future perfect tense. The same example into future perfect tense. He will have later. So the structure is subject plus will have or shall have plus V means verb plus ing plus object. And the last subtype of future tense is future perfect continuous tense. Take the same example. He will have been writing a letter. So the structure is subject plus will have been or shall have been. Will have been or shall have been plus V plus ing plus object. Here we have written will have been or shall be, shall have been after the subject. Then we have written the verb and added ing to the verb. Then we have written an object. So these are the 12 subtypes of tenses. But the three main types are there: present tense, past tense and future tense. I hope you will like my video. So please subscribe my channel. Bye bye.